I'm Jenny Simone, and I'm here at the United Nations, where Secretary of State John Kerry has signed the UN Arms Trade Treaty, insisting it will have no impact on our firearm freedoms. But already senators are lining up, putting the Obama administration on notice that the treaty is already, quote unquote, dead in the water. And as Ambassador John Bolton told me, it should be, because he called the administration's decision to sign the treaty a reversal of U.S. policy, a threat to our sovereignty, and to who we are as Americans. Take a look.
There was no consensus.
The United States is disappointed that this conference was unable to reach consensus today.
That's a violation of a commitment they made to the American people. The administration said for a long time that it would not agree to any arms trade treaty that didn't emerge with full consensus.
We look forward to the adoption of this strong treaty by the General Assembly.
Vote is as follows. 154. Abstained, 23.
Draft resolution is adopted.
And we are making a strong start today with so many signatures.
I want to be clear about what this treaty is not about. This treaty will not diminish anyone's freedom. And that's why we're proud to sign this treaty today.
That's why signing the treaty is a significant negative blow for the Second Amendment. It doesn't complete the ratification process, but it gives a law professor like Obama the hook that he needs to try and advance the gun control agenda.
This treaty in no way touches constitutional rights under the Second Amendment of American citizens.
Make no mistake, we would never think about supporting a treaty that is inconsistent with the rights of Americans, the rights of American citizens, to be able to exercise their guaranteed rights under our Constitution.
It's fairly typical of the Obama administration to say with a very straight face, this doesn't affect domestic gun control issues, something that's contrary to reality, contrary to what they're doing, and it's a tradition they will follow during the ratification process as well. You make no mistake about it.
Even if the Senate doesn't ratify the treaty, when you look at how many times this president has used executive privilege to go around the Congress, do you think he can do that with this treaty?
I think there's every indication that the Obama administration will act as though the treaty has been ratified, and he will certainly try to use executive orders to achieve his objectives even if Congress doesn't act. I think he'll be pressing the envelope, but that's certainly never slowed him down before. So the argument that even if we sign the treaty but then prevent its ratification, that the battle is over is just not true. I've long believed that Barack Obama wanted to transfer more responsibility for American foreign policy into the UN system. And there's probably no better symbol of how the administration sees that relationship than the arms treaty.
Even members of the U.S. delegation have called this treaty ambiguous. Isn't that the worst kind of treaty you can have?
I think Obama sees an ambiguous treaty as opening the way for domestic legislation and to justify, to demand that Congress pass additional gun control legislation domestically, to have a register, to have information about who owns firearms and restrictions on what the owners can do to be in compliance with the arms trade treaty. Now, I think that will be bogus, but it's the very ambiguity in the treaty language that will give Obama the opportunity to do that. You can see it coming.
The fact is, this is about international trade. It does not talk anywhere about making lists of gun owners.
But the United Nations has what it calls ISICS, the International Small Arms Standards. And there is talk that this is what the UN is going to use to give the treaty the content the treaty doesn't have. And it includes everything from registration, ban on assault weapons. Concern you?
This again goes to the point that the arms trade treaty is simply step one. I think gun registration is clearly contemplated in the treaty. Otherwise, you can't know what the supply of arms is. You can't know whether they're being exported. You can't know, therefore, whether you're in compliance with the treaty. Now, the treaty's advocates say, but there's a provision that says this doesn't have any impact on domestic firearms legislation. That's a provision in the preamble of the treaty which has no legal effect. It's there purely for camouflage, and it's just typical of the way they've gone about the negotiation of the treaty.
We all know that that's a right that's protected well in the United States. The Arms Trade Treaty is about stopping weapons getting into the wrong hands internationally.
Yeah, there's a myth that they've been able to use for several years that what they're really trying to do is stop the international illicit trade in small arms and light weapons. I think the unfortunate reality is that many countries will sign the Arms Trade Treaty with absolutely no intention of complying with its provisions, so that the dictators, the people who would use firearms to repress their people, will continue to act exactly as they have before.
Is it what we're witnessing in Syria right now proof of how a treaty like this would do nothing?
Absolutely. It's the governments like Russia, China, and others that essentially have no export controls at all that are the problem. And this treaty really is not going to affect them in a material way. And it'll be countries like the United States, which already has the world's most extensive system of export controls for the sale of weapons internationally. We will be the ones subjected to the real hidden agenda of this treaty, which is domestic gun control.
Is signing this treaty just the start of an erosion of our rights?
It's the start, and it's a real problem. I think Obama clearly does not believe in American exceptionalism. He doesn't see the United States as any different than any other country. If anything, he thinks we're too privileged, we're too powerful, and that coming down a step or two in the world is not a bad thing for the United States. So I think it's a way of reducing American sovereignty, taking it out of the hands of the American people, taking these decisions into the international arena, and getting something through the treaty process that they couldn't get through normal legislation in a democratic debate under our Constitution. I think the signal that we've sent for 4.5 years now that our adversaries and our friends around the world see is a country that's under a very weak president, doesn't care about national security issues, who's the most radical president domestically we've ever had. So I think the next 3 years are a very critical time. You've got to continue to be vigilant. I think we should make it clear that the signing of the treaty is another big mistake by the Obama administration, and that we do not accept that the signing alone gives the president any authority through executive order or any other technique to try and restrict Second Amendment rights.